As the Canadian military prepares for its upcoming peacekeeping mission in Mali, a new book is looking back at a seminal battle. In 2006, Operation Medusa was the first major combat action ever led by NATO and the largest battle fought by Canadian troops since the Korean War. Major-general David Fraser was the man commanding those NATO forces in southern Afghanistan. His new book is taking readers onto the ground and into battle. And retired Major-general David Fraser joins us in studio this morning. An honor to have you here, sir.
Great to be with you.
They say you shouldn't judge a book by its cover, but in this case, the cover is worthy of discussion. So let's start there, because the photo was taken on April 21st, 2006. There are four silhouettes, and there's a story behind that picture because something very important happened the day after the picture was taken.
So that picture was taken by my driver, Greg Moon, and that picture shows me taking off, and the four guys in the silhouettes are part of my protection team called the Posse, and then, tragically, on the 22nd of April, two of those four guys on that picture are dead. They're killed by an IED.
You set this book up in two parts. Part one deals with the lead-up. Part two deals with the battle itself. And it's the first person we meet in the pages is Sergeant Bill Irving. And he's referred to as Mother. Can you talk to me about Bill?
Bill Irving was the head of my tactical team. He actually took care of us from the moves from point A to point B, did all the protection on the ground. So essentially, he became our mother to take care of us. We all gave each other selves nicknames. He's called Mother. And he was about the only guy in that organization that could say what he was really thinking.
All right, before we move forward, let's take a big step back. And in civilian-friendly terms, in the broadest possible way, tell me what Operation Medusa was and what it meant.
What it meant was it actually was an opportunity to buy time. Buy time so the peace settlement could keep on going. It was the biggest battle because the Taliban had changed their behavior. But our task was not to lose. And where we are today, in part, is because of what the men and women did back then, because we have a peace process that carries on today.
Well, it seems to me that's a really important point, that the mission was not to lose. And as someone sort of sitting in the comfort of home, it seems that that's an interesting way of framing going into battle.
Well, today, there's no such thing as a military solution. Those days, like in World War II or in Napoleonic time, they're gone. What militaries do today is set the conditions that a peace process keeps on going.
Well, let's talk about that, because a lot of people, when they think about a military operation, they think about sort of the kinetic aspect of it. They think about the battles. They think about being put in harm's way. But there was a lot of work in 2006 that the Canadian soldiers were doing in outreach and trying to establish connections with the local Afghan people.
And that's the key part of this book. It talks about Christina Green, who came out of CETA, Pamela Isfeld, who came out of Foreign Affairs. It talks about Padre Suleiman, a Muslim padre with the forces, and how we created relationships with Afghans to actually do so much more to build a governance structure development that you and I take for granted.
Now, I want to go back to something you said just a moment ago about how in 2006 the Taliban changed their tactics. What were they doing before 2006, and what was that change?
At 2006, they were in small parties of 20 or 30 doing gunfights. Medusa, they came together as 500 fighters, top 10 commanders, including coming out of Pakistan. This was the biggest battle. They wanted to finish it. We knew by beating them on the ground, they would go back to something more devious, and that was the IED threat, which they've carried on to this day.
September 4th, 2006, you write about that day, a friendly fire incident that many Canadians will remember. It started with Charles Company and a garbage fire, which I believe you wrote about. And a split second later, Private Mark Anthony Graham was killed, and three others were injured. Take me back to that day.
It was the worst day that I can remember. I mean, that was our second friendly fire incident. The day before, Charles Company had gone on to the objective, lost four great soldiers. At 20 to 6, Shane Schreiber knocked on my door, and I knew I didn't win the lottery, and it was bad news. That was just a really bad accident.
You know, we've got so many more parts of this story to explore, but I'd rather sort of fast forward to the here and now and get your take on Operation Medusa and its relevance to this upcoming peacekeeping mission in Mali.
The big lesson for Canadians as we came out of Afghanistan with the whole government approach and how everyone can work together to concentrate our efforts that actually provides hope and opportunity, a great return on investment, and creating strategic voice. What we learned out of Afghanistan is just as applicable today on UN missions, including what we're going to do in Mali.
Is it a nomenclature issue? Because I think a lot of Canadians are asking themselves, can we go on a peacekeeping mission if there's no peace to be kept?
Well, first of all, I mean, it's we're giving hope and opportunity. Yeah. What we're doing again is buying time so that a peace settlement can be found with the, you know, all the parties and the insurgents over there. And that's not going to happen in 12 months or 24 months.
We hear a lot of one of the takeaways of this book is how well prepared the Canadian military, the men and women are to fight. But in the news, we hear of a lack of infrastructure for our military. Is there a disconnect between the men and women who are prepared to fight and the tools that they're given to go into battle with?
The men and women in the Canadian Forces and on this mission, I was the best prepared I was ever had. I was the best supported and whatnot. But the situation on the ground changes so rapidly, so fast. Medusa, we didn't plan on going on that. That was not the envisaged. But what the institution has to do is change as fast as the situation on the ground.
Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for this book. I think it's a really important piece of history. I hope a lot of people read it. Thank you very much.
Hey, thank you.